Look at that. All right. Boy, good to see you. Good to see you. I tell you what, I am happier than Jim Neighbors with a wheelbarrow full of buttholes, I tell you. That's pretty happy right there, right? That ain't just one or two buttholes. That's a whole wheelbarrow full of damn son bitches. That's right. But good-looking crowd, I tell you. Except for you. No, seriously. God bless you. I'll see you at the house. All right. Well, good to see you. Y'all is good. Let me tell you something. I don't know what I eat before I come up here, but I tell you what, I could shoot through a screen door and not touch a wire about right now. I tell you. I don't know what it was, I tell you. I think it was them dadgum fat-free Pringles potato chips is what it was. You ever eat them? I tell you what, no wonder they come in a tube. If you eat them, you're going to be hunting for something to poop in after you eat them chips. Damn, that's why I buy them at Walmart, so I can take them back. Yeah. What's wrong with them chips? They're full of turds, that's what's wrong with them. Tell you what, I am madder than a skinhead watching the Jeffersons. I tell you what. That's funny right there. I don't care who you are, that's funny right there. That's funny right there. You ever have an orgasm so good you hit the back of your head on the tub and knock yourself out? I've done that before. Thank God the VCR didn't fall in, I'll tell you that much right there. Oh, that'd be a hell of a way to die right there, wouldn't? Sitting up in their head, and how'd you die, son? Oh, damn. I electrocuted myself watching Titty Titty Bang Bang. Oh, that's right. I'm just kidding. I don't play with myself. I was cleaning it once and it went off. I'll tell you that much right there. But don't tell nobody about it, hey. It's been a while. We had a vasectomy at Sears last week. You believe that? And every time I get a boner, the garage door goes up. Tell you what, I am madder than a queer with Locke John Valentine today. I tell you what, I'm all nuts. That's upset right there. If you don't think that's funny, get the hell out of here, because that's funny right there. Man. That's a funny joke right there. That's a funny joke right there. So I was driving down the road the other day. I get a ticket for doing 61 in a 50. You believe that? Pissed me off. I about spilled my Crown and Coke. I was so pissed off about that whole thing. He goes, where are you going so fast? I'm like, I got to get these kids to school. Damn. You know, I'm in the school bus, jackass. Hello? Tell you what, I was madder than a legless Ethiopian watching a donut roll down a hill. I tell you what, I was all upset. That's upset right there. I hate driving down the highway. You ever drive down the highway and a policeman gets up behind you on the interstate and then everybody slows down and goes two by two behind the dent? He's like the interstate pace car out there, ain't he? What the hell? And then he gets off at the next exit. We're back to green flag racing out on the interstate. Get her done. That's right. That's right. I like driving too much. I like it better than flying, though, I tell you that much. I was on an airplane the other day. I had to fly to California. Good Lord. I ain't going to mention the name of the airline, but it rhymes with Northwest. And good Lord. You been on that airplane? That's the only airplane I ever been on that hit a deer. No bullshit. You believe that? Hello. And ain't flight attendants supposed to be good looking? What the hell happened to that? You should have seen them girls. I had the Oak Ridge boys with titties on the daggone airplane up there handing out pink. They were something, man. That one girl could have made Ray Charles flinch. I'm not kidding. She was something, man. They were scarier than Jan Arino coming at you in a negligee carrying a box of rubbers. That's how scary. That's scary right there. That's scary. That ain't right. Lord, I apologize for that right there. Be with the starving pygmies down there in New Guinea. Amen. But I was on an airplane and I sat next to Melissa Etheridge on there. I couldn't believe it. She had a little skirt on. I had this seat here, so I tried to get in there and she lifted her leg up and her nuts popped out. You believe that? Do you believe that? Right there on the damn airplane right there. That ain't right. Lord, I apologize for that right there. Me with the starving pygmies down there in New Guinea. Amen. That ain't right. I was in Los Angeles out there, and I got drunk one night, and I didn't know where the hell I was, and wound up in a gay bar. You believe that? Everybody in there, quick. Even the fella I was dancing with was queer. You believe that? Good Lord. I disappeared like a set of rims at a Puff Daddy concert. I tell you what, I was out the door on that right there. I was out the door on that. But they banned smoking out there in L.A. You believe that? You can't smoke nowhere. Smokers is all pissed off. They're running around.
You mean I can't have one cigarette the whole time I'm in this bar?
And here, don't laugh at that now. Don't laugh at that. That ain't right now. Hope nobody has one of them. I feel bad now. That would be funny though, wouldn't it? Somebody way up there all pissed off.
Hey, kiss my ass! Great! Jeez, you can do that!
You hear that? He tried to rush the stage. Get away from me. Good Lord. Yeah. I'll tell you what, though. I just had some good news at the house here a while back. My sister just had a baby. Nice pretty. She was in labor for 38 hours. You believe that? Man, I give up on a poop after 20 minutes. Man. Yeah, that's some stamina right there, man. She didn't even have a book to read or nothing. And then I was reading in the paper the other day, because my neighbor got up late, and I was reading in there, it's talking about this woman was in labor for 39 hours, and they ended up giving her a cesarean section. What the hell? That'd be like running a marathon and finding out you could have used a golf cart or something, bitch. You know what I mean? Good night. You would. I would have been more frustrated than a hair lip ordering Worcestershire sauce at the steakhouse. I tell you that, but that's what I did. Can I help you? I know. One thing you can. Huh? What you think, John? We got any what you think, John? How about some ketchup? Get her down. Now, my other sister, she just got married. She's a big old son bitch, I tell you straight up. And I mean that in a good Christian way. I don't mean that in a bad way. But she's something. She stepped on a talking scale the other day and said, "What the fuck? You believe that? You believe that?" She's always like, she's one of them people who says she got a thyroid problem. You know what I mean? I got a thyroid problem. Then you go over to her house, looks like a graveyard for little Debbie oatmeal cream wrappers over there. You know what I mean? You got a thyroid problem. You got a 7-Eleven problem. That's what you got. Thyroid my ass. But she just got married, and you should have seen the bridesmaid. Good Lord, they was bigger than she was. They was all lined up out in front of the church wearing matching brown gowns. It looked like a bunch of UPS trucks pulled up out in front of the church up there. I ain't kidding. His son, man, instead of the wedding march, they played Convoy through the church finger. Oh, that was good right there. She come walking in, there's a whole train of them. You was the dark of the moon on the 6th of June in a Kenworth pulling logs. Boy, I tell you what. When them church speakers belted out Cab Over Pete with Reefer on and Jimmy hauling hogs, they wasn't a dry eye in that church that day. I tell you that much. And the funny part of that wedding was she got in one of them horse-drawn carriages to tote her out of there. You ever see them get on them toting trailers, you know? Well, she got on one of them toting trailers there. She said that the horse turned around and said, "This is bullshit." Tell you what, that horse was madder than a deaf mute playing bingo, getting bingo, and trying to holler out the word bingo. I tell you, it's something like that. B5. That ain't right. Lord, I apologize for talking about the hair lip. Yeah, ha, ha. Be with the starving pygmies down there in New Guinea. Amen. Yeah, she just got married. And you know what? We went back up there. We went back up there at that church the week after for the prayer meeting up there. we was at the prayer meeting, and we was leaving the church, and I cut this feller off in my truck, right? I got a Dodge Laramie on a 12-inch, 38, 15, 40, Mickey Thompson Claus. Anyway, get her done. That's a good track there. So anyway, I cut this feller off in my truck leaving the church, right? He called me Dickweed. You believe that? Dickweed at the church. And it pissed me off. So I get out the truck and I said, let me tell you something, Reverend. You gonna call me a name, call me something, I know what it is. Dickweed, like they're growing dickweed somewhere, you know? Well, we ain't got no corn this year. We're going to stick some dickweed out there. We're going to have to spray for pussy willows, I tell you that much this year. Yeah, you don't want to mix the dickweed with the pussy willows, ain't you? Going to get a whole bunch of kumquat out there, and we can't do much with the kumquat. I don't care who you are, that's funny right there, Mike. That's good stuff right there. Yeah, but my dad, I'll tell you straight up, my dad was a preacher my whole life, and he's good too now. He knows the Bible, I'll tell you what. My dad's the only guy to make Jehovah Witnesses go, hey, we got to be getting the hell out of here, all right? I mean, this is ridiculous. We've been here for 2 damn hours. I was a Jehovah Witness for 3 weeks, and then they kicked me out of the religion. They seen my bicycle out in front of the titty bar one night out there, and I was trying to lead a girl to the Lord in there. And I would have done it too, but I come up $150 short, but I would have done it. I would have done it. I go in there all the time. It always made me upset when they tell you to get your hair cut at the church. Then you need to get your hair cut. You go to church. Well, then you look around and there's pictures of the Lord everywhere looking like the drummer for Foghat in there. You know what I mean? What the hell? Tell you what, that made me madder than a pervert with palsy trying to draw a vagina on an Etch-A-Sketch. I tell you what, that just burned me up. Burned me up. What? I tell you what, though. My parents always watch that faith healer on the TV. You ever see that faith healer, Benny Hinn? You ever see that some bitch, that little Iraqi faith healer, or Lebanese, whatever the hell he was? You ever see that some bitch? Just see what he did. Crippled people come up, and he like whack them in the head, and then they fall down, and he goes, the devil just come out. I'm like, well, God dang, it's a wonder boogers and turds and all kind of stuff didn't fly out of him. You hit the crippled guy right in the God dang head. No wonder crippled people are getting up out of wheelchairs. They think Benny's going to come over and beat the shit out of them. That's why they're getting out the wheelchair. Good Lord. You show me one verse in the Bible where the Lord run around sucker punching crippled people, all right? It ain't in the Bible. Not even in the red words. And them's the important words in there. Is them red words. I've been trying to lose a little weight. I put on some pounds. My whole family pretty big, I tell you what. And my aunt's a big old son bitch. And I mean, she could jump up in the air and get stuck. I'm not kidding. There's something wrong. There's something wrong there. But she's always on these diets that never work. You know what I mean? The other day she goes, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to get my stomach stapled. I'm like, stomach stapled? To what? The Waffle House? Yeah, thanks. You've been in there for 2 hours. I'm on that diet where you eat vegetables and drink wine. You ever been on that? That's a good diet right there. I lost 10 pounds and my driver's license on that deal in there. That's a good diet. That's a good diet right there. But I don't like to go to the gym or nothing. I hate when there's a lot of people and I'm working out, because I always get the farts on the Stairmaster down there. Ain't that the way it is? Ain't never nobody around. The minute you somewhere stationary, somebody always come up. I could be in the middle of the Gobi Desert. Ain't seen nobody for 5 days. Figure, what the hell? I'm going to pop one up right here. The minute I do, a dadgum marching band would come around the corner out there. Who farted? Shut up, asshole. You see anybody else half dead out in the desert? So I avoid them gyms. But I don't like to work out anyway. I tell you what, I hate doing that. I mean, my girlfriend always tries to make me do that stuff. She knows I don't like to go to the gym. Another day she goes, hey, why don't you go get a workout machine that we can both work out on together at the house with? So I bought her an exercise bike with a sidecar. Get it up. That's right. We was working out the other day, right? I'm in there eating a meatball sub. I'm like, oh, damn, how much time we got left on this, I'm bet. I got to get out and get some more meat sauce. I did go to the gym one time about a week and a half ago, and I'm on the gym. Sure enough, I got the farts on the Stairmaster in there. Then there was this good-looking girl coming toward me. I'm like, what the hell? I start to squish my butt cheeks together a little bit there. She coming closer. I'm like, what the hell? So I start, you know, acting like I'm crippled or something. Like, ha, ha, ha. You know what I mean? I mean, I didn't know what the hell to do. She coming closer. I'm like, good Lord. She's like, excuse me, what time is it? Oh, damn. Time for you to get out from behind me. What time it is? I'm fitting to part your hair from across the room on this DLP. Good Lord. You think anthrax was bad? Get a load of that right there. They gonna put me on the Al-Qaeda deck of cards after that bullshit. It runs in my whole family. My grandma gets the walking fart. You believe that? You know what I mean? If you got a grandma, every step she takes, something come out. You know, I'm gonna get the mail. She get the dancing, line dancing, sound like a machine gun come out of her hind end. She like, Grandpa hit the dirt. We're getting shot at. Shut up, Grandpa. Grandma got the walking farts. Now put your pants on and get out of the ditch. My grandma got arrested at the Bass Pro Shops for getting a fart. You believe that? Good Lord, they accused her of stealing the duck call and stink bait out of Bass Pro Shop. Now. My girlfriend don't like it when I talk about stuff like that in front of a lot of people. You know, she's always like, that's gross. You shouldn't talk about flatulations in front of people. There's mixed cutting out there. Don't want to hear that bullshit. And she does, women do grosser things than we do. You know what my girlfriend likes to do? Pop pimples on my back. Yeah. And don't you women, you know what I'm talking about. Every guy in here knows. My girlfriend loves it. When I take my shirt off, my girlfriend's like a retard at the Chuck E. Cheese. I tell you what. Oh, she loves that. She loves that. Let me get that pimple. You know what I mean? And it hurts like a son bitch. You know what I mean? You watching the TV. Let me get that pimple. Ah, damn. I'd rather hit my nuts with a rubber hammer and get that pimple off my back. What the hell? And the thing is, they can't just get it and go. You know what I mean? They got to dig at it for 20 minutes. You're in pain. Then they're like, well, I guess that ain't ready yet right there. You kidding me? Ronnie Millsap could have found Waldo by the time you got that pimple off my back. And she ain't immune from it either. We went out to this real nice restaurant the other day, and she goes, we's in there eating. She goes, I can't quit farting. She did. And I'm like, well, do you want to maybe keep your voice down a little bit? I mean, you embarrassing me. With the Long John Silvers, for God's sake. That woman over there wearing a nightgown is staring at us. She goes, I just let a silent fart. What do I do? Get your ears cleaned out. Hey, get her done. Something else. I don't think I'm going to get married, I tell you that much. I don't think I am. I met this girl one time. I made love to a female clown the other day, and she twisted my wiener into a poodle dog. Can you believe that? You should have seen me. I tell you, I was funnier than watching midgets run track. I tell you what, I was something else. I was something else. My brother's in a lot of trouble. My brother said to his wife the other day, he said, what do you want for your anniversary? She said, a divorce. He called me up. He was like, I wasn't planning on spending that much this year. I know what I'm going to do. I don't know, but I do love women. They say if you ain't made love in a while, it's like riding a bicycle, and that's true, because I was making love to this girl the other day, and the chain broke, and I flew over her head there and hurt my leg real bad. I was just down in Miami. I was seeing this good-looking girl for about 3 weeks down in Miami, and then somebody took my binoculars out of my pickup down there. But I was in Miami. I don't know if you've ever been to Miami, Florida, but I was down there. I went fishing down there and caught a Cuban. I was down there and got it. Lord, I apologize for that there. Me with a starving pygmy down there in New Guinea. Amen. No, but I down there in Miami down there. I met this girl who looked like Shania Twain, only a little shorter, and face was different. I was drunk, it looked like Shania Twain. Next morning, Mark Twain laying there in the bed there next to him. She was something else, I tell you what. Right down there, I ain't gonna get married. I met this girl one time, and I was asking my grandma about marriage and stuff, because my grandma good, and she's been married for many years. And I said to my grandma one time, we was talking for about 35 minutes. I said, you think I ought to get married, grandma? She said, shut the door, I'm trying to poop. Then she kept talking to me. You believe that? She's like, what do you want to get married for? You've only been dating that girl maybe 2 or 3 weeks. There's the most here now. If you're going to date somebody, you ought to date them longer than a couple weeks. Okay. God dang. Do I need to bring a spoon in there or something? What'd you do, eat the butthole out of a skunk? It's insane. It's insane. But you need to treat them girls good. And I tell you, that's where my dad's good at it. Because my mom and dad just celebrated their 50th wedding anniversary Tuesday. And that's right. Bless their hearts. But he knows the things to do. I turn her on. I tell you, they went out that night. I bet they caught 15 bass. Hello. He's something else. And you should have seen the ring he gave her. That thing there. It even had a little holder where you could have put a nice stone in it later on if you wanted to down there. I mean, that son of a bitch was nice. One year he bought her a mood ring. You ever seen that? Them things worked pretty good. When she was in a good mood, it was blue. And when she was in a bad mood, it made a red mark upside my dad's head right there. Right there. I bought him a strobe light to put in the bedroom so it'll make Mom look like she's moving when they're making love in there. That's what I bought. Get it in. That's what I bought. Oh, damn. I took this girl out the other day, and we was up at the mall. We was walking around the mall. I like taking up there, go shopping up there, what have you, buy merchandise. But we was up there and looking good, too. Little shorty shorts on, the hind end hanging out of them, a half shirt, a bald cap. Boy, I was looking good up there walking around that mall. I tell you what, I'm a piece of tail. We was going to all these stores up there, and the mall sometimes pissed me off. I tell you what, now, you ever been in that damn, what the hell, the Radio Shack? You ever been in there? What the hell? They always want your name and address. Don't that piss you off? I want that VCR. Can I get your name and address? Are you going to come over and watch dirty movies with me or something? God damn. Why don't you give me your name and address? If it don't work, I'll come over to your house and kick your ass out there. How's that sound? I got a boner ain't gonna last all week. Let's go. I got stuff to do. Let's get that rung up in there. Get that rung up. They got all kind of stuff in them stores. I went in there to the PetSmart. And you're been to the PetSmart. Let me ask you something. Is it PetSmart or PetSmart? I can't figure that out. I never know who to make the check out to up there. There's two things I can never figure out. One is PetSmart. And the other is, do midgets have regular sized turds or little midget turds? That's another one I can't figure out. I mean, they must have little teeny ones. That's what I say. I bet that yellow brick road was full of little rabbit pellets all the way up to Damn Oz up there. That's what I bet. That's what I believe. But I'm at the PetSmart up there, and don't get me wrong, I love critters, all right? I got a horse, and my horse broke its leg, though, and I had to shoot it. Yeah, and now it's got a broke leg and a gunshot wound. And I don't know what the hell you're supposed to shoot them for, but I guess it helps in the healing process or something, I ain't sure, but... But if it ain't better by next week, I'm going to shoot it again. I'll tell you that much. I'm sick of this bullshit. But I'm at the PetSmart. You know what they got in there? A dog water purifying machine. $75. You believe that? That's like Elton John thumbing through a Hustler. It don't make any sense. You know what I mean? What the hell? A dog water purified machine. I go to the girl. I go, what does that do? Little city girl come up to me. It purifies your dog's drinking water. It purifies his drinking. He ate a turd 20 minutes ago. Bert. Had his tongue up the cat's hind end last week. He ate vomit Thursday. You got any combination dog, turd, cat's hind end, vomit purifying machines in there? That's what he really needs, to be honest with you. You know, he's pretty good on the water right now. It's the other stuff, you know, kind of making his breath a little gamey around the house out there. If he wants fresh water, I'll just flush the toilet on him is what I'd do. Dog water purifying machine. Then I went into that damn Sony PlayStation place that sells all the Sony PlayStation games. What in the hell? Have you ever tried to play football on a Sony PlayStation game? Good Lord Jesus and the shepherds. You gotta have a degree from Harvard or be a damn fourth grader to play that some bitch game right there, don't you? It's so damn difficult. I go to this little kid, I go, how do you pass the ball on there? He's like, it's easy. I'm like, well, how do you do it? He's like, well, hit the trigger there, and then hit the A button, then let go of the trigger and hit the B button, then hit the trigger again, then hit A, then hit C real quick, and then hit the trigger. I got an idea. How about a button that says freaking pass? Tell you what. I ain't been that frustrated since my neighbor seen me in my window with my wiener tucked in between my legs looking at the mirror. Like you ain't done that. All right. Every guy in here done that before. Standing there with the tucked in, looking in the mirror. Hey, look, I'm Roseanne. Everybody done that. You know you have. You know you've done that before. That ain't right. Lord, I apologize for that third. Be with the starving pygmies down there in New Guinea. Amen. Get her done. But they got all them stores. They had that store where the magazines is sold and stuff in there. And Rosie O'Donnell was in there signing some CDs. Or I don't know what the hell she was doing. All I know is, have you seen Rosie O'Donnell lately? Man, she's about 3 M&Ms away from holy shit. I'm kidding you. She is. And the thing, she pissed me off anyway a while back. Remember when she had Tom Selleck on her program a while back? She blindsided Tom Selleck. He's a good fella, never hurt nobody, but he's in the NRA, so she hates that. She was like, well, you're in the NRA. Let me tell you something, Tom. Guns kill people. You believe she said that, Billy? On the Rosie O'Fatass show. She looks right at it. She says, guns kill people. Let me tell you something. Husbands that come home early kill people. All right? The gun just sitting there. If guns kill people, I can blame misspelled words on my pencil. Get her done. That's right. Yeah. Larry, what's wrong with your pencil? You misspelled some letters.
I know. My pen's all screwed up. I don't know what's wrong with it, Larry.
I went into the artifact store that sells all the Indian relics. You ever been in there? All the Indian relics? People say you shouldn't say Indian no more. Look, I used to date an Indian girl, Cherokee, all right? So I'm safe. She was mean, though, I tell you what. Her Indian name was Wrestles with Tampons. That was her Indian name. Seriously, that's her Indian name. But have you ever seen them stores that sell like Tommy Hawks and Dream Catchers? And you ever seen? Let me tell you something. Dream Catchers is the biggest ripoff I ever seen in my whole life. I bought a Dream Catcher, $29.95. Ain't caught nothing in 3 months on that son of a bitch. Just sitting on the wall collecting dust up there. I'll tell you what a good dream catcher is. My underwear. Get her done. That's right. Damn right. I caught 2 Heidi Klum dreams in there last night. Ought to string some feathers from them, hang them on the wall or something over. People come over, what's your underwear doing on the wall? No, that's a dream catcher right there. Look in there, there's still a Heidi Klum dream left in there. Turn it over, there's some stink bait. That ain't right. Lord, I apologize for that there. Give me the pygmies in New Guinea. Amen. That's something else. All them stores. All them. Went into the record store. Boy, I tell you what. You ever see them punks that work in the record store? Them some bitches pissed me up. Good night. They got the pants hanging off their ass. I didn't know that was a fashion statement. I thought a rapper got shot and he was wearing their pants at half mast. That's what I thought it was. I didn't know what the hell was going on there. I didn't know where that was. Y'all got tattoos. Let me tell you something. If you're going to get a tattoo, get one that you can take off. One day, because you will be old. Look like a dumbass one day. My sister got one. Look like a jackass. She got one right here. Says, let go of my ears. I know what I'm doing. Right in the back of her damn head. You believe that? You believe that? Unbelievable. Unbelievable. 14 years old. She got that tattoo in the back of her head. It's a wonder they didn't take her kids away from her. You know, they was, you know, they, get her done. You know what? You know what they was selling in there? Yoko Ono records. Now, what kind of waterhead retard is buying a Yoko Ono? She like a turd that won't flush. Yoko Ono, I mean. Good Lord. Yoko Ono. Hey, you want to come over and listen to my Yoko Ono record? Hey, you know I'd love to, but I'm going to put my wiener in a meat grinder here in about an hour and a half. I'd be right over. Skip to Maloo. Of course, they still got the Dixie Chicks records in there, and everybody's mad. Let me tell you something. Everybody's mad at the Dixie Chicks. I'm going to tell you straight up. I think they're pretty girls. I think they're good singers. But I think that little fat one needs to shut up, is what I think that needs to happen. I mean, good night. Ain't that a son? Ain't that crazy? She's like, well,
I don't understand why everybody's mad at me. I just said that I didn't agree with what was with Natalie. Here's the problem. You're a country singer. That's a patriotic fan base you got. I mean, you might as well went down to a trailer park with a megaphone and started yelling, Walmart sucks. How about me? I mean, unbelievable. But the thing that pissed me off, she's always railing on Toby Keith, and people like Toby Keith, and she does not stop talking about him. I mean, that whole thing would have blown over, but she keeps talking about Toby Keith. She's like, you know, it's music like his that make people think country music's full of back-ass rednecks. Well, don't you sing a song about killing a guy named Earl? I mean, God damn. Let's face it, if it weren't for them two good-looking sisters, she'd be working at Elaine Bryant in Nashville somewhere. All right. That's what I say. Get her done. That's right. That's right. Oh, man. Oh, I got to tell you this. I got thrown out of JCPenney. You believe that? For fondling up the mannequin. And that ain't my fault either now. They got some good-looking plastic women in there. I tell you what. I mean, I was horny. I could eat the crotch out of a Raggedy Ann doll in there. I tell you what. They had some stuff in there. And they taunt you. That's what pisses me off. They throw me out for fondling up a mannequin. Then you walk in there, there's this plastic redhead standing there, little mini skirt on, almost seen the giblets. It was so damn short on her. She had her arm up, kind of waving me over. I mean, if you ask me, the little whore was asking for it, if you ask me. That's right. You don't dress like that at Penny's. I almost broke its arm when I dry humped it on the outdoor chair out there. And that's the funny thing about them mannequins. You can only get the legs so far toward the ear. You know what I mean? And it just snaps off like a damn twig on a tree. Snaps off like a twig on a tree. I like a lot of them stores. I was in the Victoria's Secret. That's one of my favorite stores right there. Now, I like that. I'm like a retard in a room full of bouncy balls up there. I tell you what, I like that place. I was up there a couple weeks ago. I was sniffing around up there and my aunt was with me. My aunt is 297 pounds. And my aunt walks in there and she goes, I want to see some sexy underpanties in my size. The clerk goes, me too. Well, they got all kind of stuff in there. They got these britches in there for women that go right up the ass crack. You seen them? Thong britches. Go right up the hind end. And I know why they call them thong britches, too. You see a girl in them, you're like, thong, wah, 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 wah. That's right, they call get her done. You know that's right. You know that's right. But girls look good in them thong britches. Except big girls. They shouldn't wear the thong britches. I seen a big girl in them. It looked like she's fitting to go pull a Jeep out of a ditch or something. You know what I mean? She put the hook in that strap right there. Put it in neutral. Good Lord. Good Lord. Thing I can't figure out is y'all women wear them string britches up your ass cracks all day long. You take them off, they're clean. How the hell? How in the world do you keep your underdrawers clean when they wedged up your crack all day long? I mean, that's got David Copperfield going, how in the hell do they do something like that? I can't figure it out. You give us fellers a pair of under britches, about an hour later, look like we come back from the mud hole in the four-wheeler, about an hour later out there. And that's true. The Lord give us a different hind end or something. My butthole got a leak in it, I'll tell you that right now. I have got a leak in my butthole, sure as I'm standing here. Sometimes I gotta put plumber's cock in my ass crack, seriously, to see if I can find a leak or something, you know? Stick the plumber's cock up there, look in the mirror, see if I can see it bubbling or something in there. Hey, baby, it's bubbling right over here by the mole over here. You think I'm kidding? You think I'm kidding now? They got all them drawers. I like them crotchless drawers. You ever seen them? You believe this? Women paying like $15 for a pair of undershorts that ain't got a crotch. Flying out of there, too, like goddamn hotcakes. Just boom, boom, $15. Britches with no crotch. I'm thinking, good Lord, I got a whole drawer full of them at the house. I bet I'm sitting on $200-$300 worth of britches that ain't got a crotch. There was a girl put them on for my birthday one time. I come home, she was like, you want some of this right here? I'm like, no, look what it did to your underbritches over there. God damn. What the hell? That looked like a good place for a plug-in or something right there. Cinnamon sticks, some potpourri, something in there. Put some Twizzlers up there. They got all kind of that stuff. Then they got them eating britches. You ever seen them? What in the hell is this country coming to? We live in a country, some of the best food you can eat. Refrigerators full of chocolatey treats and damn pot pies and all kinds of Little Debbies. We eating undershorts. Kids starving in other countries. What do you want to do tonight? Let me eat them underpanties right there. Give me a glass of milk. I'm going to dunk them some bitches right over here. Start a whole new franchise of dunking bitches all over the country. Guy sitting at work. I'm going up to dunking bitches. Y'all need anything? Yeah, give me some small ones. Them big ones will give me diabetes. I bought this old girl one time 5 pair of strawberry eating britches. And I bought 5 pair because I always end up eating 2 or 3 pair on the way over to her house. And I tell you, them some bitches are good right there. I'm glad they don't make them in biscuits and gravy. I'll tell you that, but good night. I tell you, I be getting fat just on undershorts. Doctor called me up, you gained 10 pounds last week. I ate a lot of crotch last week. Need to make some fat-free underbreeches is what they need. Need some Snackwell panties, that's what they need. Honey, I'm on a diet. Put on some fruit roll-ups, would you? Do some, stick your carrot up your hind end. I'm trying to cut back. I was with this one girl one time. She put on banana underbreeches, like strawberry, banana cream, something. And we was making out. We fell asleep. Woke up in the morning. Her whole crotch was covered in sugar ants. You believe that? Big string of them right from across all the way to the screen door right there. She woke up, I'm over with a can of Raid going, shh. She's like, what are you doing? Never mind. Never mind. But then they have these britches for fellas in there, and I don't know if you've seen these, but on Valentine's Day, they got these little shorty short underbritches in there. I mean, they're so damn tight, they got hearts on them. You know, I don't know who the hell, look a little queer to me. If you ask me, I ain't gonna wear them britches. We walk in there, my girlfriend goes, hey, try on them little shorty short britches right there. I'm like, bullshit. So I go in there and try them on. Sure enough, split my boys in two places. Oh, it was horrible. I had one nut come out the left side, another nut come out the right side. I even had a nut I didn't know about come out them someday. She's like, come on out, let's take a peek at you. That's all right, I'm going to stay here. So I go walking out there. Got my stuff hanging out. It was embarrassing. The girl that worked there didn't know what the hell was going on. She's looking at me like, what the hell? Did you sit in gum? Shut up. Sit in gum. Yes, scrotalicious. That's what I said. Ridiculous. Sit in gum. Sit and go. Tell you one thing, though, the britches are getting shorter and shorter. I tell you what, good night. You got to be trimmed up real good now. You see some of these bikinis at the beach, it's a good thing them girls shave up. And that's sexy, too. You got to like a girl that trims up real nice, and I like that, you know. I mean, you don't want it. You don't want to be with some girl and she take her britches off, look like a ZZ Top concert down there. You know what I mean? You don't want that to happen. I was with a girl one time, she slipped out of her drawers. I'd have a shotgun to shoot the quail coming out of some bitch out there. What the hell? Good Lord, I needed a rubber and a permit. That's what I needed. Good night. But you want them trimmed up. But the thing is, women are making fellas. They think that's sexy now when fellas trim up. You believe that? Let me tell you something. Y'all get them ideas out of them girl books that y'all read. My girlfriend was reading one of them damn books, and she had that. What was that book y'all read that? No, what the hell was that? Oh, the Hog Hunter. She's reading the Hog Hunter. She's reading the Female Hog Hunter. And she goes, hey, why don't you shave your private parts for my birthday? It'll look sexy. I'm like, bullshit. So I'm in there shaving my scrotum in there. Yeah. Yeah, that was real sexy. I come out of the bathroom with little red bumps and toilet paper squares all over my testicles. Good night. Looked like I pooped a weed eater in the goddamn bathroom. And if I was a girl, I'd never shave. I'll tell you that much. I'd be at the beach looking like I was smuggling Chewbacca in my undershorts. That's what I look like. Big old hairy Chewbacca at the beach. That'd be me. That's ridiculous. Because I ain't shaving. I ain't shaving. I was with this girl one time. We was drunk over at the neighbor's in the tub. And she said that. She goes, I want you to shave me. I'm like, what the hell? Get her done. I know. So I'm shaving her back in the tub there. I took this girl out the other day. I got so damn pissed off. I get irritated. I'm going to tell you what irritates me. I took this girl out the other day. We go up to Arby's. You ever been to Arby's? What the hell? There's some dumb people up at Arby's, ain't they? I was up in the fast food restaurant up there. There's some dumb. Let me tell you something. Everybody up there graduated magna cum numnut up at that fast food restaurant. If I'm lying, I'm crying, I ain't shed a tear. You want to have some fun up there at the Arby's up there? Do this. Get you 3 beef and cheddar sandwiches in there. All right? Your order going to come to $4.81. Give that fella in there working the register $10.01. Oh, yeah. Kick back and watch the fun begin at the Arby's up there. Good Lord, he's running around. They're calling managers in. God night. I swear they could fall in a barrel of tits and come out sucking their thumbs up here at the goddamn Arby's. And the thing that pisses me off about fast food restaurants, nobody speaks English no more. Ain't that some of the fast food restaurants? Good night. In the United States of America, learn a little bit of English. I mean, especially if you're at a daggum. Especially. And there ain't nothing wrong with saying that. You live in the United States. That's the language you speak. Especially if you're at a fast food restaurant. I mean, at least learn the word sandwich. You know what I mean? And the thing that pissed me off about it, nobody knows English. But meanwhile, I watched Star Trek the other day. The captain flying around all these planets I ain't never heard of in my whole life. The other day, he's talking to some guy with a horn growing out the side of his head. Some bitch spoke perfect freaking English. You believe that? I can't get Paco to get my onion rings on time up there. It's unbelievable. Unbelievable. People that sue everybody pisses me off, too. Don't that piss you off? I hate them people. Oh, cigarettes gave me cancer. I'm gonna sue cigarette companies because they give me cancer. Well, it says on the box you're gonna get cancer. What else? You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna sue Hustler magazine for giving my wrist carpal tunnel. How that sound? Right? Get her done. That's right. There's a guy down there in Florida got his leg bit off by a shark. His wife suing. The county I live in down there, she goes, my husband got his leg bit off by a shark and nobody jump in and save him. No shit. It's a freaking shark. Get off your fat ass and jump in there. That's like asking a retard to beat up Jackie Chan, you know what I mean? Waterhead getting his ass kicked. I tell you what, put that shark in the parking lot of Walmart, I'll kick the shit out of it all day long. I mean, that's like wiping before you poop. It don't make any sense to do something like that. Then there's a feller got hit by a train down where I live in Sanford, Florida. Get hit by a train. He wasn't drinking nothing. Just an idiot, all right? He get hit. How the hell do you get hit by a train? I mean, it ain't like it's going to swerve and miss you at the last minute. You know what I mean? You got the tracks right there, kind of giving you a little heads up something may be happening and in this area right here. You know, ain't like it's going to pop out from behind the bushes. You know what I'm saying? If you ever get attacked by a train, do this. Ta-da! Yeah. Get her done. Ain't that something? And the funny thing is, he survived, and everybody was like, oh, he's lucky to be alive. He's lucky to be alive. He got hit by a friggin' train. Yeah, he's real lucky, and he look at him over. Got him strapped to a wheelchair. No legs, no arms, half a head, no nose, one ear, eyeball screwed up. How you doing, Dougie?
Hey, wait a minute, Dougie.
Hey, you lucky son of a bitch. You are a lucky bastard. You know that? You are a lucky bastard. Does that make any sense? They can't find Osama bin Laden. Don't that piss y'all? They can't find Osama bin Laden, but yet they can find 5 pot plants on my 10 acres. You know what I mean? Figure that out. Get her done. You know what I mean? Ain't that sad? Good night. They go, it costs $4 billion to try and find him. Well, we're paying the wrong person too much money. Shit, I got a buddy who'll do it for tickets to Travis Tritt. Shit. I'll get him on my deer rifle. That's what I'd do. I got a deer this year, 300 yards with my Ruger, by God. Thank you. But hey, it was at the zoo. It don't count. All right, but still, I still got the son, bitch. I felt bad, too. There was a kid feeding it. You know what I mean? A mom was over. Hey, I needed them horns, all right? Kiss my ass. I needed them deer horns. I'm sponsoring one of them starving kids. You ever done that? Let me tell you something. This is the biggest ripoff known to man. And I like to help people out. And I was doing it for 3 years. I was sponsoring. I adopted one of them little peckerheads down there. All right? Seriously, let me tell you something. True story. I get a letter in the mail the other day. Certified letter. All right, the kid that I adopted busted up a bunch of stuff, and I got to pay for the damages. 7 million pygmies, I got the gang member. Ain't that son? I ought to fly down there and stick my boot up old Boobla Boobla's ass is what I ought to do. Now I got to fly down there, go to parent-teacher conferences. You believe that? What am I going to say down there? How y'all doing? What the hell? I did get a letter from him, though. I did get a letter from Boobla Boobla. And I sent Boobla Boobla a care package. And Boobla Boobla sent me this letter back. Says, here. Dear Larry the Cable Guy, thanks so much for the fly swatters. They sure come in handy on them muggy nights. I appreciate the PlayStation, but there ain't no place to plug it in down here. Why can't they make a button that just says pass? My brother, Booble Bobble Booble, got hit in the head last night by a flour bag during a food drop. He's having a rough week down there. I shrunk a missionary head last night and put it on a stick. So you'll be getting it as soon as UPS starts to deliver again down here. The last driver ended up in a kettle of taters and roots. Tomorrow we're going to go hippo gigging. It's like frog gigging, but with hippos. Last time I hurt my back because they made me carry the decoys. Mom's all excited because they're going to show her boobs on the cover of the February National Geographic. She just rode a wild hog over to tell the neighbors. Well, I gotta go. There's a lion running around in the shrubbery. And if you ain't out of the way of them lions when they're... Oh, damn, I hope he's okay. Oh, boy, lions are getting a lot of people. They got that old, what's his name, that queer tiger trainer out there. And did you see that? Good night. Can you believe it? They were going to kill the tiger, but the judge ended up just charging it with date rape. Lord, I apologize for that. That ain't right there. They were the starving pygmies in New Guinea. All right. Hey, I'm going to sing you a couple songs here, by God. It's time for some song singing. What do you say? Get her there. Let me just plug my cord in I got right up here. And we're going to make some beautiful music together. Hope you like this song here. Hope you like this song here. This is very special to me, so we're going to sing it here today. I'll never forget the words my daddy told me before he passed away. What the hell? Let me come back to that one, all right? Let me do this song. This true story. My brother is deaf. Honest to God, you can ask anybody that knows me. And he's been talking like this with the sign language his whole life. And my mom talks to him like this with the same deal. And I tried to learn how to do that, but I can't get a finger in edgewise with them two loud mouths. But he's a pretty good songwriter, and I couldn't believe that he can write songs. But he had Ronnie Millsap looking at one here not long ago, but he wrote this song 3 days ago. I promised I'd play it for him. It goes like this. That song. Right. Now you get that song is called "Hurry Quick, the Living Room's on Fire." Hope you like this song. It's called "I Can't Get Over You Till You Get Out From Under Him." No, seriously though, let me do this song here for you. Sing along if you know what this song's called. My grandma's got worms. That explains why she's been dragging her butt on the carpet. Sing along. A lot of the older people might know this song here. Let me tell you this story quick off before I do that. My grandma, this is a true story. She was in the finals of the fart contest in Jacksonville, Florida. And she was doing real good, and she was in the final round. She was farting the song Elvira by the Oak Ridge Boys. And she was going for some extra points in the middle of Giddy Up, Papa, Mau Mau. And she shit and got disqualified. And it was a horrible tragedy. It was a horrible tragedy.
You want to hear my impression of Elton John? He's queer. That's the impression that I get, all right? I don't know about y'all, but that's just the impression that I'm thinking, all right? Well, I was watching a dirty movie, and I got so damn turned on, that I dialed a 900 number, and I think I got my mom. That ain't right. All right, let's not sing any more songs. Seriously, if I can't sing right, I'm not gonna sing it up. All right, I'm gonna tell you what I'm gonna do. I had some people wanting me to do this, and I always like to do this before I get out of here. And y'all been a real nice crowd tonight. I appreciate y'all coming out. And thank you so much. We appreciate it. And I always like to, when I get done, I always like to go out and shake hands and tell people hi. So come on up and say hi to them if you get a chance. And shake my hand or whatever you want to do. Come on up and do that. So we'll be out front for you tonight. All right. I'm going to end my program tonight on stuff that everybody wants to hear, and I hope you won't hear them tonight. I had some people ask me for them, so we're going to end it. We're getting close, so they're going to sing some Christmas carols for you tonight. So I hope you like these. Get a job, you bum 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 bum. Money don't grow on trees, you bum 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 bum. Silent farts, deadly farts, all was calm. Not for long. Oh, come all ye legal immigrants, come and get them green cards and learn some damn English and then how to drive. Heart the hair, lip angel sing, but it does anyone care. On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me, clap, and I left her. Blue balls, it's dollar night at the titty club. Donnie the retard had an 8-pound waterhead. He was 5'3" and he said to me,
I like tater tots.
Lord, I apologize for that.
Better watch out. I think she's a guy. I ain't quite sure, but something ain't right. Hillary Clinton's coming to town. Get her down! Hey, thank you so much, everybody. I appreciate it. Thank you very much. You guys are awesome. Thank you.